Building trust by selling with integrity. I am very pleased to welcome you for the second presentation of our three-part series, Selling with Integrity. I discussed in the first part two different concepts of selling, both relying on the relationship between seller and customer. I want to thank you for the feedback you provided. Following your suggestions, I'm going to add an example demonstrating the value of excellent customer relationships in terms of profitability. After that, the focus will move to Amazon's business model. A special thank goes to Isio Godwin for his suggestion to study Amazon's history. He led me to buy the following book. One Click, Jeff Bezos and the Rise of Amazon.com, Penguin 2011, by Richard L. Brandt. It is a fascinating book full of insights and background information. Additionally, I found on YouTube two equally fascinating videos about Jeff Bezos. At the end of this presentation, you will find an opportunity to download the links. I also mentioned in the last presentation my time as a manager of a natural food store. I want to add a short anecdote from that time. When I just started to work in the shop, I didn't know too much about organic food products. Although I learned quickly, I realized soon that knowing everything about every product was not the top priority. The question of all questions was, do people believe my words? During my first days in the shop, I discovered the existence of two distinct categories of cheese. Cheese made with rennet coming from calf stomach, and cheese made with vegetarian rennet, which often involves the use of genetically modified microorganisms. We had vegetarian customers who would not touch a cheese made with calf rennet. And we had other customers who would not touch cheese produced with an enzyme connected to genetically modified bacteria. In the afternoon of one of my first days in the shop, a lady came in and asked me about a specific cheese and what type of rennet was used. At the time, I didn't even know what rennet is. I told her that I did not know the type of rennet used in that cheese. She then explained to me why it was important to her. So I picked the phone and called the producer of the cheese to get her that information. I think today that her real intention was to test what I know and how I react if I don't know. This lady called the owner of the shop 2 years after I had left and told him she wants me to come back to run the shop again. Let's now move on and have a quick look at the value of customer relationships in terms of profitability. The numbers for the example I choose come from the accounts of Volkswagen and their Porsche luxury car unit. At the end of this presentation, you will find the opportunity to download the raw data behind this comparison. I chose Volkswagen and Porsche because they are business units of one and the same corporation. They share technology, factories, suppliers, cost structure, and accounting practices. But when it comes to profitability, Volkswagen and Porsche live in different worlds. In 2014, Volkswagen sold cars for almost 100 billion euro, while Porsche sold cars for roughly 18 billion euro. For the profits, Volkswagen made profits of a bit less than 2.5 billion euro, while Porsche made a profit of more than 2.7 billion euro. which means the return on sales 2014 for the Volkswagen brand was 2.5%, while for Porsche it was 15.8%. I used for this example numbers from the year 2014. That year the Volkswagen fraud was not yet publicly known. This fraud allowed Volkswagen to produce millions of cars cheaper and with a better mileage by cheating on emission tests. Porsche, on the other hand, was less affected because they sold only very few diesel cars with the Volkswagen engines in question. If anything, Volkswagen's short-term profitability should have gained by polluting the air much more than advertised. The reason for Porsche's higher profits is simple: higher prices. The Volkswagen Touareg with a diesel engine is almost identical with the Porsche Cayenne diesel car. The technological cores of both cars are identical. The fine-tuning of the cars is different, yet both provide the same level of luxury. But the 2016 Touareg with a 3-liter diesel engine carries in Germany a list price of €53,700, while the Porsche Cayenne with the same engine goes in Germany for €69,949. This makes a price difference of €16,249. Some people think that Porsche earns more because they sell to rich customers who do not care about money. In reality, the rich and the poor like their money, and the rich people are generally less likely to throw their money away. But we see that people are buying a car for a significantly higher price than the cheapest vendor is asking. Obviously, they need a compelling reason to pay that higher price for the same product. If the product is equal, the price difference needs an explanation apart from the product. It reflects the different customer experience provided by Volkswagen and Porsche. Customer experience includes how they handle prospects during the sales process and how they handle customers during the complete product lifetime. Many customers of Amazon cannot afford to pay a premium for perfect service, but they still appreciate to be treated decently, and Amazon strives to provide perfect service. People love it and run in droves to buy through Amazon. This means Amazon uses perfection of customer experience to fuel unprecedented growth of their business. Amazon's market environment could not be more different from the luxury car market, which is Porsche's home turf. Amazon started out selling books, which behave in many ways like a commodity. Provided a book is not torn or otherwise damaged, all printed copies of a given book are identical. Prices tend to be moderate, and so are the price differences between retailers who carry the book. Amazon's founder Jeff Bezos chose this market not by accident. He knew how to do market research and how to position a business. He chose to start with a book-selling business not in spite of its commodity-like characteristics, but because of them. Why? If everything else is equal, sales process, fulfillment and after-sales services make the difference. And Jeff Bezos focused from day one on perfect customer service as foundation of his business. But there is another difference between Porsche and Amazon. If you sell a product with a price tag of $80,000, a salesman may close one deal per week. This allows to handle every customer with great personal attention and care. Amazon earns in many cases less than $5 from a single sale, and they cannot provide personal attention to a customer at this low price point. But Jeff Bezos recognized earlier than anybody else the potential of the internet for automating sales and customer care systems. The definition of automation is creating a system repeating again and again a clearly defined process with little human intervention. Automated systems can be hugely efficient. Even the Chinese economic planners had to discover that workers costing only $1 per hour cannot compete against machines. But automation implies high fixed costs and needs high volumes to be profitable. Amazon used the money, which was freely available for internet startups in the late 1990s, to build volume and scale up their automated systems. Unlike other companies, which went belly up after the stream of cheap money had dried up, Amazon had not burned all the money for marketing expenses and price wars. Instead, they had built a sophisticated system consisting of a huge IT infrastructure and top-notch warehouses at strategic locations. With the help of this infrastructure, they could provide excellent customer services at relatively low cost. In 2001, when the business cycle turned into recession mode, Amazon's systems were still very efficient, although too big and way too expensive for the stagnating sales volumes. But because their systems were so powerful, they found new corporate customers who would use their infrastructure and pay for it. This was the birth of Amazon's first business services: Amazon Marketplace and Amazon Web Services. Amazon was now a retailer and a digital service provider. Amazon provides digital services to a wide variety of customers. They include huge global corporations, small and medium-sized businesses, independent artists publishing their own artwork, and finally retail customers. But they sell all their digital services using the same three steps: open a relationship, build trust and authority, sell Amazon's digital service. Amazon's most important services for businesses are Amazon Web Services, Amazon Marketplace, Amazon Pay, and Amazon Voice Services. I just wanted to mention these business services. For the purpose of this presentation, I want to focus on Amazon's marketing to consumers, because this is visible to everyone. Amazon's most important digital services for consumers include the Kindle ebook system, the Audible audiobook system, video and music streaming, and cloud storage space. These core digital services are all connected to the Amazon retail business through Amazon Prime. Amazon Prime is sold to retail customers for a yearly flat fee. The main benefit of Prime is the free express delivery for most purchases shipped by Amazon, sometimes even if they are not sold by Amazon. Prime also allows for free streaming of thousands of movies and songs in high quality formats to many platforms, including TV sets. If your TV doesn't connect to your local network, there is an inexpensive piece of hardware to provide that connection. You find a myriad of small links pointing to Amazon Prime on every Amazon product page, search page, or category page. Two such links are located inside the page header, and one more is connected to each product with a free express shipping option or free streaming option for Prime customers. For frequent buyers, this is a no-brainer because it won't take too long until the money is back through savings on shipping. Add to that a 30 days free trial, and who can say no? Amazon Prime is sold for an annual fee. Although there are those two links in the header of all Amazon web pages, you find the strongest pitch on the checkout page, where you see shipping costs and the offer for free express delivery for Prime members. This means that Prime benefits are only available to people who have demonstrated that they are prepared to spend money. Because Prime is the main promotion tool for Amazon's streaming services, freebie seekers leave empty-handed and have to try their luck somewhere else. Prime offers currently more than 1800 movies and a million songs for free streaming, without advertisements. Prime members pay only if they order a hard copy or download file. Free streaming Prime videos count for roughly 7% of all videos available at Amazon. Prime Music shows a similar ratio. In connection with Amazon hardware, Prime allows also access to the Kindle library. You may borrow one Kindle ebook per month. Millions of ebooks participate in the library program. Prime offers on top a small piece of free cloud space. My brain is not made for movies, and neither do I stream music from Amazon. But Amazon knows very well, after watching a movie or listening to an album, I might want to buy it. If I like a book, it is even more likely that I decide to add that book permanently to my library. And while choosing the album, movie or ebook, I am exposed to many other titles not included in Prime. Each ebook, movie or album provides a perfect starting point for the legendary Amazon sales machine. And now that machine starts humming. This title sounds also great. There is a trusted relationship. One click, and oh, I have it. This is another example showing how simple selling can be if the conditions are right. One of the most important things in life is to choose the right friends. They have the power to lift you up or to drag you down. If you run a small business, chances are that you spend most of your time with your customers. If you want to enjoy your life, you need the right people around yourself. And if you want to base your business on friendly relationships with your customers, you have to choose them carefully too. Qualifying process is marketing speak for a system to find and attract the right customers. It will be the topic of a third presentation of a Selling with Integrity series. You will learn how to determine which customers are right for your business, how to find and attract them, and how to keep others away. I thank you for following this presentation to the end. This tells me that you are serious about building a positive and stable relationship with your customers. You have earned your access to the materials I used in this presentation and your invitation to the next presentation. Claim them now. Enter your name and email address into the form below so that I can send you materials and invitation.